Hey Hawks, welcome back to another episode of Hawk Talk TV. I'm Jay Wizzy, in the flesh. Let's get into it. Did you miss the blood drive? Well, don't worry. Last Friday, Hawk Talk 2 members went to the upper gym to interview students, workers, and even the event planner on the experience with Southage's blood drive, plus the importance of donating.
Why did you donate today?
I donated because of the cool Snoopy shirt, obviously. You know, it's pretty cool, and it's nice to help people out, so donating blood is a good thing.
Actually, I'm kind of scared of like donating blood. I just want to like conquer that fear in a way.
I donated because I read somewhere that for every bag you donate, you save 3 lives.
Would you recommend donating to someone?
I would totally recommend donating. Like, other people need it, and it's like life or death kind of sometimes. So if you can give it, you should give it to them.
I'd say yeah. It's not like it doesn't really hurt at all. You just kind of lay there for like 5-10 minutes and then it's over and you're done. So, and you get the rest of the day off school, so I'd say yeah.
What would you say to someone who's scared to donate?
I would say most people are scared to donate. Even I've been working at the Red Cross for 5 years. I was a phlebotomist for 4 years. I don't like needles. No one likes needles. It's normal to be afraid of needles, but you do it because it's the right thing to do.
You can visit redcross.org and you can pull up a bunch of blood drives in the area that you live in, and we also have a fixed site in Portland at the Vancouver fixed site if you guys would want to drop by anytime.
Last Tuesday, we had our annual diversity assembly. We saw many performances from multiple different cultures. Reporter Brooke Reynolds and Emilio Ortega have more information on the event.
Okay. That was the first try. I'm pretty sure that was a test run, because I don't think you guys were loud enough. No offense.
Did you learn how to do this?
So from a young age, we've been taught by like our mothers, aunts, cousins, you know, we just like pass down the dances from like each generation. It's just like a given thing in the islands. So.
In our Tongan culture, we dance to a talunga, and basically for us, it's to show like your purity, and like it shows girls who still like have their virginity, I guess. No, that's what it is. It's a virgin dance.
So we come from the island of Polynesia. Specifically, we are Tongan, and so when we move like the ocean, we move like the water, and we represent grace and tranquility when we dance.
¿Cómo siento estar enfrente de todas esas personas?
Pues la verdad, un poco de nervios al principio y al final igual. Pues
sí, porque bueno, por una parte fue nuestra primera presentación tocando para mucha gente, pues. Y sí, estamos un poco nerviosos.
Pues a mí no me dio nervios, pero como que no nos habíamos preparado el sonido y pues no sentí que salió bien.
¿Cuál fue tu favorita canción para tocar hoy?
Yo pienso que la de Lolo Félix.
Personas gustaban el Ella Baila Sola, ¿cómo sienten tocar esa canción?
Pues al principio las personas empezaron a cantar y se sintió chido, ¿me entiendes? Bueno, se sintió bonito.
Sí, se sintió bonito cuando varias personas reconocieron la canción y se sintió como que más ganas para tocar.
Have you ever watched American Idol? Well, here at Southage, we have our own version. This year, an annual Southage Idol will take place on May 9th. Students will show off their musical talents and impress the judges and audience. Auditions are now closed, but make sure you go and support your fellow Skyhawks May 9th and 7th in the auditorium. On April 28th, Southage Choir partook in Oregon's State Ensemble Contest. The Sopraltos, Southage's treble group, placed 4th place, while the Yoko Bros, Southage's tenor and bass group, placed 3rd place. Then, the day after, Moises Ortiz, a bass singer, placed 5th place in Oregon State's solo contest. Congratulations to everyone who participated in the contest. Last week, 6 speakers gave presentations about the beauty and history of Africa, including Algeria, Zimbabwe, and Somalia. They told us about their heritage and where they come from. And they also showed us items that represent their culture. Then they talked about the struggles of being a refugee and an immigrant.
Somalia is race camels a lot. And the richest you are, the more camels they have. So this one we call Kor, which is the mark of, they put the neck of the camel, and it has different noises.
Our chess club was recently in Oregon's K-12 tournament. Let's check out the results. The school placed 8th with Shunkai Peng being the top board player of the tournament, with 4 wins and 1 draw. In addition, Rojman Tajipur and Lorenzo Freddy had strong winning performances. Adam Rounds and Nicholas Melvin played well and scored some points for Southridge. Good job, Hawks. Checking in with golf, it's been a wet and dreary start of the season, but last week saw clear skies for Metro League play at the Portland Golf Club. For the boys, Julian DeBruge had a Southridge low score of 87, Jace Grenzer had an 89. Also, in the mix was Keenan Recamp, Wesley Dodd, and Morgan Dodd. For the girls, Amelia Duffy and Esther Kim played the course. Best of luck, golfers, as you continue your season today at regionals. Now we go to Mason and Fatima to talk about the problem with Southridge bathrooms.
As many of you know, the bathrooms here at Southridge have been closed numerous times this year. Vandalism, messes, and safety concerns are all elements that have our bathrooms in and out of commission. The bathrooms have been said to be constantly messy in a state of disrepair. But we wanted to hear what students at Southridge had to say about the bathrooms.
How does using the Southridge bathrooms make you feel? What do you see? Tell us about your experiences.
Well, we don't have like any of the bathrooms. There's like one open in the front, super crowded, like 30 people in there, and I never can use it. It sucks.
Honestly, it's a little crowded in the mornings. Like the sinks are always full, but it's pretty like, it's okay.
They're always out of tampons.
Yes, they never have.
Always.
Like, and then like, I don't know, they don't like refill the tissue sometimes. It's like, what, it, you know.
Well, certainly there's vaping. We can smell it even if we don't catch them in the act. But a bigger deal, it seems to me, is that I do know we have students who have talked to their administrator, to their parents. They feel intimidated, afraid to use the bathrooms because of the number of people hanging out there. So that's we need to get a handle on that. That's not acceptable.
It just feels really uncomfortable to use the Southridge bathrooms, mostly because people use it inappropriately. And even if you do need to use the bathroom, it kind of deters people from using it just because of the environment that people create in there.
And I've seen the Instagram of the Southridge bathrooms, so there are interesting stories. And yeah, that's what I've heard about the Southridge bathrooms.
Now we go to Fatima and Mason to talk about a beautifully made memorial for two of our very own Skyhawks.
This April 27th marked the one-year anniversary of the passing of Southridge students Matthew Amaya and Juan Pablo Pacheca Aguilera. There is a memorial for them located near the athletics parking lot on the field. We talked to Carla Ramos about the memorial.
So what does this plant symbolize?
This plant for me really symbolizes like friendship and strength.
So how would other students use this space for themselves?
I would say it's a place to like get together and really tell stories. That's what I've been doing, just going outside, hanging out there. You're welcome to hang out there and leave some stuff and, you know, just enjoy and remember our friends.
That's it for now, Skyhawks. I'm Jay Wizzy. I'm from the 503 and the BSD. Come visit me at 6047 Southwest 185th Avenue. I'll see you next time.